everybody, welcome back to Out of This World Arts and Crafts. For this week's craft, we're going to use our painting and drawing skills, ooh, and some fun materials to make some salty space drawings. Yay, look how colorful and salty they are. If you're really interested in this craft, keep on watching. Okay guys, so to make our salty space paintings, here's a little close-up of mine. We're gonna need a couple supplies, so you're gonna need paper, preferably black paper. It just seems to make the colors pop out a little bit more, but if you have other paper or you want to try other paper, go for it. You need some watercolors, a pencil, a cup of water, paper towel as you can see, some glue, and some salt, and this can be table salt, that's totally fine. So the first thing we're gonna do is draw a space scene with our pencil. So I think I'm going to do a planet theme. I kind of liked how this turned out, but you can choose whatever you want. You could do rocket ships, you could do the sun or the solar system, kind of whatever you would like. But the first thing you're gonna do is definitely draw what you want on the paper. So go ahead, pause this video. I'm gonna do the same, I'm gonna pause the video, draw the thing that I wanna do, and then when you're done, just come and start the video again. All right, sorry, I got a little ahead of myself. But once you're done with your drawing, you're gonna use your glue and outline your drawing and whatever lines you would like to use with your glue. So I would choose to do the lines that are super important, that are super dominant, maybe not such the, like the smaller fine lines first, and go over that with glue. So I'm gonna trace the perimeter with a fair amount of glue, not a ton, but just enough. Okay, so once you're done lining all your lines with glue, just make sure you go over some of the sparse spots. So I noticed that I had some lines that could be covered a little bit more because we do want a fair amount of glue just so the salt can stick. So I'm just gonna go over some of those real quick. So the next thing we're gonna wanna do is sprinkle our salt. So you're gonna take your salt, I have mine in a nice little cup, and we're gonna put a pretty good amount of salt on this thing. So, you're gonna put the salt and sprinkle it over the glue. We wanna cover it as best we can. So go to town, make it look like it's kind of snowing. Might be a little messy, but that's okay. Art's all about getting messy sometimes. So when you think you're getting close to done with the salt, you're gonna have to wait and let it dry for, well, until the glue is dry. Okay, Space Cadet, so when everything is dry, you're going to use your watercolors. So open up your watercolors and you're gonna get your brush wet. And then you're gonna pick a color of your choice. Now, let's pause for a second. What I love about this project is that you can blend some beautiful colors together. So you can put any color you want next to each other and blend them together and get some, you know, like darker blues or darker purples, some bright oranges. There's a lot of blending you can do, so don't be afraid to blend. So I'm gonna take my brush, and I think I'm gonna start with yellow for the sun that I kind of made here. So, dipping my brush in some water, getting it into the yellow. And I like to spread the yellow out a little bit on the lid of my watercolor. When you paint with the paint, you're going to want to just kind of like dab it on to the salt, not kind of like brush strokes per se, but just kind of dab it with your color. So I'm gonna show that real quick a little closer. Just kind of do.
That way you're not moving the salt around too much and you get to keep a pigmented color while spreading it through the salt, not necessarily through your brush. So now I'm dipping into some orange. I think I'm gonna mix it with the yellow on the lid to get kind of an orangish yellow, kind of a sunrisey color. It's okay if a little bit of the red gets onto my earth planet here. You see it kind of spread on there. I'm just gonna mix it in with some blue and it'll get to be a dark blue purple. I think that's gonna look really pretty. There's another thing I wanted to tell you guys about. There's this NASA's art challenge. Every month they have a new art challenge. And I think we're gonna put a link on either this video or the YouTube site so you guys can check it out. But there's been like calendar challenges so you can make your own calendar. There's an image you can, your own drawing that you can submit to NASA and then they pick it for a calendar. And each month there's a new one. So we're just gonna put a little link to the challenge and maybe a little description in the bio of this video or on our channel. So just check that out if you're really interested. It's super cool, super fun thing to do if you have extra time or if you just really wanna get more involved. It's a great thing to do. All right, Space Cadets, it looks like I'm done. It's still a little wet as you can see, but the salt and the paint's dry. You can see we got some nice mixing moments here, some new colors, some lettering. I tried to write MSU on Planetarium, got a little lost with the salt, but I think it turned out pretty good. So if you would like to share your own artwork with us, I would love to see it. So please send MSU on Planetarium an email and include a picture of your artwork in there, and I can't wait to see what you guys have created. So until next time, keep creating, keep being artistic, keep trying to experiment and try new things. See you next time, guys. Bye.